your hands with water. Apply soap, wrap your hands palm to palm, and wash the backs of both hands and in between your fingers. Then palm to palm with fingers interlocked. Clasp your hands together and rub, and then clean around the thumbs too. Rub your fingertips in the palms of your hands and finish off with the wrists. Rinse your hands really well with water and dry them thoroughly with a paper towel. Use the towel to turn off the tap. Your hands are now clean.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of Allah, who is the most merciful and most gracious. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. How are you all? Hopefully, you all will be fine and good. Well, first of all, I would like to say you welcome you all in my social studies class of grade 2. This is revision week. Revision week number 2 and lecture number 1. As you know, my name is Mrs. Sadaf Amreen. Before going to start our today's lecture, here are some general instructions. So listen carefully. Dear students, first of all, you have to mark your attendance. Secondly, keep ready your book, notebook, pencil, eraser, and sharpener to note down the answers of the questions. If you have any question, please ask questions in the WhatsApp group. Hope the instructions are clear to follow. Contents. What we are going to study in this lecture. As you know, this is revision week, so we will do revision of lesson number 8, building houses, lesson number 13, animals around us, and all copy work and book work of these two lessons will be revised in this lecture. Okay, so get ready for that. Let's get started. Revision of building houses. Okay, so first of all, we will revise this lesson, all the main concept that we have studied in this lesson, and all the book work and the copy work we will revise. Okay, so get ready. Unit number 4, buildings, and lesson number 8, building houses. We have studied this lesson. And we have studied different things, like we have studied in different kinds of houses in this lesson. So here you can see different pictures of different houses: tent, igloo, straw hut, village hut, a block of flats, and an under construction double story house. Okay, there are different kinds of house. People live their house because house is very much important for them. Everyone need house to feel safe, to live safely, so they built their houses according to their requirement. Okay, so how they built, what are the requirements to build a house, we will study and we will revise in our next slide. Building houses, building materials. Okay, so whenever anyone can want to build a house, they require some materials to build a house. And what are those materials? Cement, stone, steel, wood, clay, and bricks. So these are the materials that that everyone require when he or she want to build a house. Okay. Tools. Building houses, builders. Okay, in this lesson we have studied about different builders who built the houses. Okay, no single one can build a house. There are different people or different workers. They can work for building a house. Okay, so the very first person, that is an architect who set or draw the map of a house. Then there is a plumber, fits all pipes and tabs, and a labor dig, lift, carries things, and help the other workers. Okay, so a brick kiln worker bakes bricks for the building, the walls, and the carpenter make the windows and doors, and he work with wood. An electrician puts in all the wire and the plug points. A painter paints the wall and the wooden frames, and a plasterer covers the walls with the smooth layer of plaster. So here you can see different builders means different workers. They work for building a house. So no single one can build a house. We need different people for different work. Like electrician, we need electrician work. We need an electrician person for painting the walls, painting the doors. We need a painter for plaster, to plaster the wall, and we need a laborer to lift or digs or carries things and help other workers. We need carpenter also. So plumber, carpenter, and architect, the very first person that is required to draw a map of a house. So all these are builders or workers that we require to build a house. Okay. Tools. These workers use different tools to make their work easy, and they can save their time also by using these tools. So there are different kinds of tools. You can see here: hammer, saw, chisel, pipe wrench, drill, screwdriver, plier. So there are different tools of there are different tools that different worker use according to their work or according to their work requirement. Okay, so they can use these tools and they can save their times, and these tools helpful to make their job easy. Safety. Yes, tools are useful, but you can hurt yourself if you use them badly. Okay, so be careful while using tools. Okay, so take care of them, use them only for the job they were made for. Okay, so if you want to use a tool, you should be very careful and use use that tool only for the job that were made for, that they were made for. Okay, so here we have studied about the tools and how to use safely. So in the next, we will start our book work, and after that copy work. Okay, now we have finished the main points of this lesson. Now book work. So get ready for that. Work page, exercise E, page number 44. Here what we have to write, exercise E is you also used tools for reading, writing, and drawing. So your books, pencil, brushes, etc. are your tools. Okay, list all the tools you use while studying. My tools. Now here some tools are there, like books, notebooks, pencil, color, brushes, eraser, sharpener, and ruler. Okay, these are the tools that you require to study. Okay, while you want to study, you need some books, you need some notebooks, you need pencil to write, you need colors to color in different pictures, brushes also you require to paint some paintings, and eraser, sharpeners, and ruler are very much important that you have required while you study, while you were studying. Lesson number 8, building houses, work page, exercise C, page number 44. Here we have to write name the person who. Okay, so here are some works are written, so we need to write the person name who are doing this type of work. Okay, like number 1, puts in the pipe and taps, that is work done by the plumber. Ye kaun karta hai kaam? Ye plumber karta hai. Number 2, works with wood, carpenter. Number 3, design the house, architect. Okay. Number 4, carries, lift, helps, and digs, that is labor. does the electrical work, electrician, builds the wall with bricks, bricklayer, puts plaster on the walls, plasterer. Copy work now, lesson number 8, building houses. Phillips 1, 2, 3. Okay, there are 3 Phillips. Number 1 and dash is made of ice block, that is igloo. Number 2, straw hut is made up of straws. Yes. Number 2, dash is made up of straws, straw hut. And dash is made up of logs, log cabin. You can see in this picture, this is the log cabin. This is the log cabin, igloo, and this is straw hut. Okay. So number 1, an igloo is made of ice blocks. Number 2, straw hut is made up of straws. And number 3, log cabin is made up of logs. Okay. Now we have revised all the book work and copy work of lesson number 8, building houses. Now it's turn to revise the next lesson, that is animals around us. Now we will revise lesson number 13, animals around us. Okay, so get ready. In this lesson, we have studied about wild animals and domestic animals. Here you can see some wild animals. Look at here, lion, zebra, bear, polar bear, and hippo, crocodile, giraffe, tiger, monkey, chimpanzees. So these are all wild animals. Wild animals are very dangerous animals. They cannot live with us, so they live in the far away place, you can say, in the forest or jungle. Okay, because they are very dangerous, they can eat us, they can harm us, so we cannot live with them. So they live in the forest. Okay, so they build their house according to their requirement. They can build their own houses in the jungle, and they live over there. Okay. So where wild animals live? Wild animals live in the forest, and wild animals live in the river. Look at here. This is a crocodile. Okay. It lives in the river, and tigers and others wild animals live in the forest. Domestic animals. These are all domestic animals: dog, cat, cow, parrot, horse, goat. These are all domestic animals. Domestic animals are friendly animals. They can live with us, and we can keep them in our homes, and they can live on farms also. They are very useful. They are very sweet, lovely. Okay, so these are all domestic animals. Domestic animals are very friendly. They can live in our homes. Okay, and they can live on farms. You can see this picture is of a farm. Okay, so they can live on the farms because they are very useful. We can get different benefits from them. Okay. These animals are source of food. Some animals are source of food, and some animals are used for traveling or as a transport, and some animals are used to make the clothes also. Like we can get wool from sheep, and we can use this wool to make the warm clothes, sweaters, like that. Okay. And first of all, look at here, hen. We get eggs from hens. Cow, milking a cow, we can get milk and meat from the cow. And this is we can get wool from sheep. Okay, and we can get milk and meat and leather from buffaloes, cows and goats. So these, we can get different benefits from different animals. So we can say that animals, some animals are source of food and transport. Okay, so look at here, elephant. Elephant is a very big animal. So horse and donkey is here, horses, ponies, camels and bulls, pull carts and wagons. Donkeys, camels and horses carry loads, and elephant moves heavy logs. We must be kind to animals, okay? So animals are very much important for us. They are source of food, they are also source of transport, so wish, and they are also living things, okay? So we need to take care of them. They can feel like we are feeling some pain or some grief, so if we hurt them, they can feel same as we feel, okay? So we should take care of them. We should take good care of them by providing good food, healthy food, and keeping their homes clean, and we should not hurt them and disturb them. So we must be kind to animals because they are living creatures, okay? So they are also living creatures like us. As we are human beings, are living creatures, so the animals are also living creatures, so we should take care of them. Book work, okay? Lesson number 13, animals around us. Work page number, exercise A, page number 64. Okay, so this is exercise A. Unscramble the names of these animals. These are names of some animals. We have to unscramble them and write again, okay? So the very first is elephant. Then number 2 is ponies. Number 3 is camel. Number 4 is horses. Number 5 is bullock. And number 6 is donkey, okay? So this work we have done on page number 64, that is exercise A. Lesson number 13, animals around us. Work page, exercise B, page number 64. Okay, this is exercise B. Talk about the animals mentioned on page number 62 and 63. Then fill in the following boxes. Some animals can be named in both in the groups. We get food from, yes, we get food from cow, goat, hen, fish, buffaloes, sheep, okay? We can get food like milk, egg, and meat. So we use these to move heavy goods, okay? We use these animals as a transport, like donkey, horse, camel, bullock. They can move heavy goods, and so that we can use them as a transport, okay? And so this is work page, page number 62 64, exercise B. We have done this. Now the next exercise, exercise C, page number 64, work page. Okay, work page, exercise C, page number 64, lesson number 13, animals around us. So what is this? Color this picture and write a few sentences about it. You have to color this picture and you have to write some lines about this picture. So it is Hamid's camel. He is traveling to a faraway village in the middle of the deserts, and he only has his camel. It is very hot during daytime. So this is exercise number C of this lesson. Work page, page number 64. We have done this. Now we have revised all the book work of this lesson. Now it's time to revise the copy work of this lesson. So get ready for that. Copy work, okay? So lesson number 13, animals around us. Question number 5. What is question number 5? Why should we be kind to animals? The answer, we should be kind to animals because they are living creatures and very useful for us, okay? So we should be very kind to the to animals because they are living creatures and they are very useful. This question we have done on the notebook. So the next is true false, okay? True false. There are 5 true false that you have done on copy. Number question number 1, write true or false. Number 1, wild animals live in houses. False. Number 2, some animals can be trained to work. True. Number 3, elephants cannot move heavy logs. It is false. We get eggs and meat from chicken. It is true. We must not be kind to animals. It is false. Okay. So this exercise you have already done. So I will just revise it, all these 5 true false. Lesson number 13, animals around us matching. Okay, there are 4 matching questions. Like wild animals, we will match with live in the forest. We get wool from sheep. We get milk and meat from cows and goats. And horse and bulls pull carts and wagons. So we have to match the horse and bulls with pull carts and wagon. So now we have revised all book work and copy work of this lesson. Lesson number 13, animals around us. Okay, so what is the home task for you? Home task. Learn all copy work and book work of lesson number 8, building houses, and lesson number 13, animals around us. Okay, so you have to revise and learn all the book work and copy work of these 2 lessons. Okay, this is your homework. This is all about from my side. If you have any question, you can ask in the WhatsApp group. Okay, thank you for listening and watching this lecture. Stay blessed always. Allah Hafiz.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم my dear friends welcome in Islamiyat class I hope you are fine and happy with your families my dear friends as you know it is your Islamiyat period I am Mrs. Amara Zubair and it is our Revision week First, I want to tell you about the contents. Today, we will revise the worksheet number 1, worksheet number 2, and worksheet number 3. So, dear students, if you have the print of worksheet, so take out your worksheet, okay? Dear students, now we will revise the worksheet number 1. So, listen carefully. Word bank has given with the help of these words, we will complete the blanks. So listen carefully. Use these words to fill in the blanks. Kaaba, Hajj, Prophets, 1,24,000, Sahih, false. Number 1. Allah sent more than 1,24,000 prophets. Allah sent more than dash prophets. Allah sent more than, right here, 1,24,000 prophets. Allah sent more than dash prophets, right here, 1,24,000 prophets. Allah sent more than 1,24,000 prophets. Number 2. Allah gave some sahifas to some of the prophets. Allah gave some dash to some of the prophets. Allah gave some sahifas to some of the prophets. Right here, sahifas, S-A-H-I-F-A-S. Sahifas to some of the prophets. Allah sent us his messages through his dash. Allah sent us his messages through his prophets. Right here, prophets. P-R-O-P-H-E-T-S. Prophets. Right here, prophets. Number 4. The Kaaba. Number 4. The dash is most sacred place for all Muslims. Right here, Kaaba. The Kaaba. K-A-A-B-A. Kaaba. The Kaaba is most sacred place for all Muslims. Number 5. Muslims perform dash in the month of Zilhajj. Muslims perform dash in the month of Zilhajj. Right here, Hajj. H-A-J-J, Hajj. Muslims perform Hajj in the month of Zilhajj. Question number 2. Answer true, false. If the statement is true, write right there true. If statement is wrong, then you write false. Okay. Number 1. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam came for the whole world for all times to come. Yes. So write here true. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam came for the whole world for all times to come. Number 2. Allah is not our Lord and Master. Allah is not our Lord and Master. No, it is wrong. Allah is our Lord. Allah is our Master. So, it is false. Number 3. There will be life after death. Yes, it is true. Number 4. Arabs did not forget the teachings of prophets. No, it is wrong. So, right here. False. Kaaba is in Medina. Kaaba is in Medina. No, Kaaba is in Makkah. So it is false. Right here. False.
No, dear students. No, we will match the following words. So listen carefully. Number 1. The Holy Quran. The Holy Quran. We match it, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Holy Quran, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Number 2, Anjil, Anjil, Hazrat Isa alaihi salam. Anjil, Hazrat Isa alaihi salam. Number 3, Zabur, Zabur, Hazrat Dawud alaihi salam. Zabur, Hazrat Dawud alaihi salam. Turat, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. Number 4, Turat, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. Ji beta, ye to bahut easy thi. Matching to aap sab bachon ko aati hai aur sab bache bahut ise like bhi karte hain. To sab bachon ne isko complete kar liya hoga. No, we will do the question number 4 and the last question of worksheet number 1. So listen carefully, circle the correct answer, circle the correct answer. Two option has given, you will choose the correct answer, circle it and write here, okay. Number 1, prophets received dash from Allah, prophets received wahi from Allah. So circle the wahi and write here wahi. Number 2, The teachings of all the prophets were the dash. The teachings of the all prophets were the same. Right here, same. Circle the same. S-A-M-E, same. And right here, same. Number three. Allah will dash those who obey him. Punish, reward. Who obey him, reward. Allah will reward those who obey him. So, circle the word reward and write here. Number four, Hajre Aswad is called dash, the white stone, the black stone, black stone. Hajre Aswad is called the black stone. Number five, there were more than dash idols inside the Kaaba. 500, 300, 300. Circle the 300 and write here 300. There were more than 300 idols inside the Kaaba. Now, my dear students, now we will revise the worksheet number 2, unit number 9 and unit number 11. Use these words to fill in the blanks. Word bank has given. With the help of these words, we will complete the blank. So, listen carefully these words. 7. Generous. Twice. Iman. Medina. Number 1. Dash is our faith. Dash is our faith. Dash is our faith. Iman. Iman is our faith. Right here. Iman. I-M-A-N. Iman. Number 2. There are dash beliefs of our Muslims. There are dash beliefs of our Muslims. There are 7. 7 beliefs of our Muslim. Right here, 7. S-E-V-E-N. 7. S-E-V-E-N. 7. Number 3. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam was very dash. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam was very generous. Was very generous. G-E-N-E-R-O-U-S. Generous. G-E-N-E-R-O-U-S. Generous. Number 4. Muslims migrated to dash. Muslims migrated to dash. Medina. Muslims migrated to Medina. Right here, Medina. M-A-D-I-N-A-H. Medina. Muslims migrated to Medina. Number 5 and last. Share your dash with your friends. Share your dash with your friends. Share your twice with your friends. Share your twice with your friends. Twice. T-O-Y-S. Twice. T-O-Y-S. Twice. Question number 2. Answer true or false. Number 1. A Muslim does not have iman. A Muslim does not have iman. No, it is wrong. So, it is false. Number 2. If we have iman, we accept what Allah says without any doubt. Yes, it is true. If we have iman, we accept what Allah says without any doubt. Yes, it is true. Number 3. Some people don't have a home. Some people don't have a home. Yes, it is true. Right here, true. Number 4. Abdul Sattar Iddi was a social worker. Yes, it is true. Abdul Sattar Iddi was a social worker. It is true. Number 5 and last. We should not share our things with friends. We should not share our things with friends. No, we should share our things. So, it is false. It is false. Next. No, we will match the following. Ansar, number one, Ansar. Ansar, the Muslims of Medina. Ansar, the Muslims of Medina. Number two, Muhajirs. Muhajirs, the Muslims from Makkah. Muhajirs, the Muslims from Makkah. Number three, share things happily. Number four, beliefs are seven. No, last question number four, circle the correct answer. Two answer has given, which one is correct? We will circle it and write here. Okay, number one, Iman is our dash. Iman is our doubt, faith. Iman is our faith. Write here, faith. F-A-I-T-H. Faith. Number two, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam led a very dash life. Simple, lavish. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam led a very simple life. S-I-M-P-L-E. Simple. Number three. We have strong belief in dash God Allah. We have strong belief in Allah. A-L-L-A-H Allah. Number four. Islam teach us to be dash. Islam teach us to be generous, miser, generous. Islam teach us to be generous. Right here, generous. G-E-N-E-R-O-U-S. Generous. Number five, Abdul Sattar Idi was a famous scientist, social worker. Social worker. Right here, social worker. Abdul Sattar Idi was a famous social worker. Now, dear students, my dear students, now we will revise the worksheet number 3. Use these words to fill in the blanks word bank has given. So, listen carefully. Number 1. Muslims perform dash in the month of Zulhajj. Muslims perform dash in the month of Zulhajj. Right here. Hajj, H-A-J-J, Hajj, H-A-J-J, Hajj. Muslims perform Hajj in the month of Zilhajj. Muslims offer dash and free food in Ramzan. Muslims offer dash and free food in Ramzan. Muslims offer iftari and free food in Ramzan. Right here, iftari. I-F-T-A-R-I, iftari. Right here, iftari. I-F-T-A-R-I, iftari. Number 3, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam was born in the tribe of Dash. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam was born in the tribe of Quraysh. Quraysh, Q-U-R-A-I-S-H, Quraysh. Q-U-R-A-I-S-H, Quraysh, right here, Quraysh. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wa sallam was born in the tribe of Quraysh. Number 4, Khana Kaaba is a house of dash. Number 4, Khana Kaaba is a house of Allah. Khana Kaaba is a house of Allah. A-L-L-A-H, Allah. Khana Kaaba is a house of Allah. A-L-L-A-H, Allah. Number 5. Allah sent flocks of dash. Allah sent flocks of birds. Right here, birds. B-I-R-D-S, birds. Know the question number 2. Answer true or false. If the statement is right, then you write the T are true. If the statement is wrong, then you write the false. R or F. Okay. Number 1. Quraysh were the guardians of Khana Kaaba. Listen it again. Crash were the guardians of Khana Kaaba. Yes, it is true. So write here T. Number 2. Surah Al-Fil is in the chapter 20 of Holy Quran. No, it is false. Write here false. Number 3. Abra was the king of Syria. Abra was the king of Syria. No. Abra was the king of Yemen. So it is false. Right here, false. Number 4. Laylatul Qadr comes in Ramzan. Laylatul Qadr comes in Ramzan. Yes. It is true. Right here, T. Right here, T. Number 5. Most Muslims give their zakat in Ramzan. Most Muslims give their zakat in Ramzan. Yes, it is true. Right here, T. Okay. Now, dear students, it is the last page, page number 2, worksheet number 3. Question number 3. Match the following. Eid ul Fitr. First of Shawwal, yes, we celebrated first of Shawwal. Yes, Eid ul-Fitr, first of Shawwal, Eid ul-Adha, 10th of Zulhajj, 10th of Zulhajj, Eid ul-Adha, 10th of Zulhajj. Number 3, Abra, king of Yemen, Hazrat Ibrahim alayhis salam, prophet, The last question, circle the correct answer. Two options has given. You will choose the one and write here. Okay. Number 1. Laylatul Qadr is better than a dash months. Laylatul Qadr is better than a dash months. Thousand. So write here thousand. 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 Laylatul Qadr is better than a thousand months. Number 2. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhis salam was ready to sacrifice his nephew's son. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhis salam was ready to sacrifice his son. Right here, son. S-O-N, son. Number 3. Muslims offer Tarawih prayer just after dash. Number 3. Muslims offer Tarawih prayer just after Isha Fajr. Isha. Right here, Isha. I-S-H-A, Isha. Number 4. Muslims fast in the month of dash. Muslims fast in the month of dash. Muharram, Ramzan. Ramzan. Muslims fast in the month of Ramzan. Number 5. Abra had a dash army. Small, big. Abra has a big army. Right here, big. B-I-G, big. Now, dear students, it is your classwork. No, it is the homework time. You learn all the worksheet and revise all the work at home. Okay, beta? If you have any question, you can ask your Islamia teacher. Thank you, my dear students, for listening to me. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Fi Amanillah.
Assalamu alaikum and good morning everyone. Welcome in computer science class. I am your computer science teacher, Ms. Zarmina, and today we are gonna start lecture 1 of week number 15. So now get ready, as today we are going to revise all of the computer book work. All of the exercises we have done, we are going to revise all of these exercises, and the chapters are chapter 5, 7, 8, 9 and 12. One by one we are going to revise each chapter's exercise. So get ready. Chapter number 5, we will start with chapter number 5, editing in notepad. Quickly open your book, page number 26 and 27. Make sure if you missed any question or any exercise, do it right now, like during the revision class, okay? Page number 26, we will start with exercise A. In exercise A, it is written that it is about fill in the blanks with the correct word. Word bank is given and we have to fill the blank with the correct word. So we are going to revise one by one. Get ready for it. So number one statement is, dash means to look for any text you want to search for in your document. Yes, now think carefully and tell me the answer. Now who's going to tell the answer, which is the right one? Dash means to look for any text. So here is a big hint for you. To look for, it means if you want to look for any text you want to search for in your document. Yes, very right, good. It's a find. So find means to look for any text you want to search for in your document. Now let's move on to number two. Dash means making a copy of text from a document and placing it in the clipboard. So it means you have to copy any text that is on your document, and that text will move into the clipboard. Okay, so which is the right one? Yes, copy. Copy is the right one. Like copy means making a copy of text from a document and placing it in the clipboard. Now let's move on to number three. Dash means canceling the previous result. Which is the right word? Like it means canceling the previous results. Yes, undo. If you want to cancel the previous results or changes, you will click or you will just press undo by using keyboard shortcut. Okay, good. Now number four. Dash means moving a section of text from document to the clipboard. Read carefully. It means dash means moving a section of text from the document to the clipboard. So if it is, the right option is cut. If you want to cut, when you cut any text, then it is removed from the document and is on the clipboard. Now let's move on to number five. On number five, dash means to change any text with the one you want in your document. Okay, it means which word will come over here. Only two options are left, replace and paste. But so dash means to change any text with the one you want in your document. So the right answer is replace. If you want to replace any word, like if you want to change any word, then you will just click on the replace. So replace means to change any text with the one you want in your document. Let's move on to number six. Dash means copying or moving text from the clipboard to the document area. Now it means that you are moving or copying the text from the clipboard to the document area, that you, the text you have like cut any text, now you want to move that text anywhere else in the document area. That means, what is the meaning of this sentence? It means paste. Yes, paste means copying or moving text from the clipboard to the document area, anywhere anywhere else in the document. Okay, now let's move on to exercise number B, page number 27. In exercise B, we have to take the right and cross the wrong sentence. Let's start with number 1. Undo erases the last change done to the document. Is it right or wrong? Undo erases the last change done to the document. Yes, it's right. Okay, so you will put tick or mark tick in front of that sentence. Now let's move on to number 2. The file menu provides all the editing options. The file menu provides all the editing options. No, file menu doesn't provide any editing options. Just file menu provides the options like you can save, you can print, you can create new file. All of the editing options are on home tab and insert tab. Okay, and let's move on to number 3. The editing options can be used quickly through keyboard shortcuts. Yes, we can do all of the editing options with the help of keyboard shortcuts. Good. Now let's move on to exercise C. That is on page number 27. That is about the keyboard shortcuts. Exercise C, it says write short keyboard shortcuts for the following menu options. So here you can see different options: cut, copy, paste, undo, find and replace. So one by one we will write the keyboard shortcut. So what is the keyboard shortcut for cut? As you already know that we have to press CTRL. So for all of the options, CTRL remains the same, but the next word will change. That is for cut, CTRLX. So you have to press both of them together if you want to cut any text from your document. CTRL, Control X. Okay, now if you want to copy the text, which keyboard shortcut you are gonna use? Yes, Control C. If you want to copy the text, you will press Control C. Okay, now number 3, if you want to paste any text, which keyboard shortcut you're gonna use? Control V. Very good. Now move on to number 4. If you want to undo or cancel the changes, then which keyboard shortcut you're gonna use? Well done, you are going to use Control Z. Now move on to number 5. If you want to find any word in your document, which keyboard shortcut you're gonna use? Yes, very good, you are going to press Control F. And number 6th one is replace. Now if you want to replace any word with the new word, which keyboard shortcut you are going to use? Excellent, you are going to press Control H. So these are some of the keyboard shortcuts. Control button remains same, but the next word will change according to the option. Control X for cut, Control C for copy, Control V for paste, Control Z for undo, Control F for find, and Control H for replace. So now move on to the next chapter, that is chapter number 7, Document in WordPad. And book exercise A, B, C and D, page number 37. Open page number 37. Chapter 7, Document in WordPad. And we are going to revise exercise A, B, C and D, page number 37. So starting with exercise A, fill in the blanks with the correct word. We have to fill the blank with the correct word and the word bank is given. Zoom in, zoom out and 100%. So let's start start reading number 1 statement. Number 1 statement is says like is this: dash button makes the page look smaller. Which button makes the page smaller? Is it zoom in, zoom out or 100%? Yes, zoom out. When you click on zoom out, then your page will look smaller. Now move on to number two. Dash button makes the page look bigger. Okay, which button? Zoom out is out, like we cannot. There are two options, the left, zoom in and 100%. Which one is the correct? Zoom in or 100%? Very good. Zoom in is the right option. Like zoom in button makes the page look bigger. Okay, now number third one is dash button makes the page fit in the window. So it's obviously 100% is the right option, as 100% makes the page fit in the window. Okay, now move on to exercise B. Exercise B is about tick the right and cross the wrong sentences. Page number 37, same page. Now look at number exercise number B. And number one statement is, WordPad is not a text editor like Notepad. Is it right or wrong? This sentence is wrong. It is actually a text editor like a Notepad, but it has more features. So it's the right sentence because it is a text editor. Now let's move on to number two. In WordPad, you can use colors for your text. Yes, we can use colors. So that's it. Statement is right. Okay, now number third is, in WordPad, you cannot add pictures to a page. Is it right or wrong? Yes, it's wrong, because in WordPad, we can add pictures to the page. So this statement is wrong. Now, let's move on exercise C. Write the names of two tabs in WordPad. So you have to write the names of two tabs. These are the two tabs. You can see home tab and view tab. So home tab and number two is view tab. Remember, there are only two tabs on WordPad. You can find home tab and view tab. Okay, only two tabs, home tab and view tab. These are two names of the two tabs in WordPad. Now let's move on exercise D, that is, the keyboard shortcut for saving your file is, so what is the keyboard shortcut for saving your file? Very good, that is Control S, as saving start with S, and the keyboard shortcut is also S, so Control remains the same for all of the keyboard shortcuts, and you will just write S because saving your file, you will just click Control S and S start, like saving, the word save or the saving start with S, and shortcut is also S. Very good, everyone. Now let's move on to chapter number 8, formatting in WordPad, page number 41 to 42, and exercise A, B, C and D. Now open page number 41, as we are going to revise chapter number 8, exercises. Okay, exercise A, page number 41, fill in the blanks with the correct word. Words are given below, like text color, bold, font size, font family, alignment and italics. We will read one statement, one by one each statement, and then fit the or fill the blank with the correct one. Starting with number one, dash means to change, to arrange the text on left, right, or center of the document. So which word is the right for this statement? Dash means to arrange the text on the left, right, or center of the document. Yes, alignment. Alignment means like to arrange your text either on the left side or right side or even in the center of the document. So the correct statement, the correct word for this statement is alignment. Let's move on to number two. Dash button changes the size of the text. Which button changes the size of the text? Is it text color, bold, font size, font family, or italics? Yes, that is a font size. Like with the help of font size, you can change the size of the text. Now let's move on to number 3. Dash button makes the text dark and thick. Which button is used to make the text look darker and thicker? Excellent! Bold button. Yes, bold button makes the text look darker and thicker. Now, number 4. Dash button changes the color of the text. Which button changes the color of the text? Very good! Text color, as the names indicate. Text color. So, text color button changes the color of the text. Let's move on to number 5. Dash makes to the text look slanting. Okay, which button makes the text look slanting or sideways? Italics. Yes, very good. Italics. Now, number 6. Dash changes the look of the text. Which button changes the look of the text, look or the style of the text? Font family. Well done, everyone. Font family. Like with the help of font family button, you can change the look or the style of the text. Very good. Now, let's move on to page 41, exercise B. In exercise B, tick the right and cross the wrong sentences. Okay, we have to read the statement and tick the right one and cross the wrong one. So, number 1, aligning text means to make it look beautiful by giving it different colors and changing in its size. Is it right or wrong? Aligning means? No, it's wrong. Formatting, actually. The formatting means to make it look beautiful by giving it different colors. And aligning means to arrange the text either on the left side or the right side of the screen or even in the center. So this statement is wrong. Now, page 42, exercise B, part 2, that is statement number 2. Text highlight color makes the text look like it was marked with a highlighter pen or marker. Is it right or wrong? Yes, it's actually right. Because with the help of a text highlight color, when you use this button and make your text highlight, then it looks like it is being marked with a highlighter pen or a marker. Very good. Okay, so that is right. Now, exercise C, page number 42. Name any 4 buttons from the paragraph group. Okay, we have to write the names of 4 buttons from the paragraph group. Here you can see the paragraph group. So, first you can write any 4 of them. Okay, you can write any 4. So, let's start with number 1, that is align left, align right, line center or even center, and line spacing. Here you can see line spacing. This one is line spacing. And start a list is also in the paragraph group. Start a list, line left, line center, line right, justify is also in paragraph group, and line spacing. So these are the names of 4 paragraph group buttons. Now let's move on to the next question, that is exercise D, page number 42. Name any 4 buttons from the font group. Here you can see font group, and you have to write any 4 buttons. You can write or like any 4 buttons. So now I'm going to write with font size, bold, underline, italics. You can even write font family, color, text color, or text highlight color. Okay, so all of these are in the font group, so you can write any one of them. Font size, bold, italics, and underline. These are the names of 4 font group buttons. Now, let's move on to next chapter. That is chapter number 9, pictures in WordPad. And now we are going to revise exercise of this chapter, that is chapter number 9, page number 47 to 48. So open page number 47 and 48. Okay, page number 47, exercise A, fill in the blanks with the correct word. Okay, so we have to fill the blank with the correct word. Words are given and we just have to select the right or choose the right option and just fill the blank with that word. Number one, dash button allows you to insert pictures from your computer into your document. Is it start a list, paint drawing, or picture? Yes, it's picture button. With the help of picture button, you can add pictures to your document, into your document. Now, number two, dash buttons allows you to choose different lifestyles. Yes, which button allows you to choose different lifestyles? Good, it's start a list button. With the help of start a list button, you can choose different lifestyles. Like you can start a list with numbers, so alphabets, small alphabets, or even in Roman numbers. So now move on to number three. Dash button allows you to insert drawing created in Windows Paint program. Which button allows you to insert a drawing created in Windows Paint program? Yes, paint drawing. With the help of paint drawing button, you can insert drawings that are created in the Windows Paint program. Now let's move on to B, exercise B. It says to tick the right and cross the wrong sentence. Page number 47, okay, and 48. So number one, date button allows you to insert date and time in your document. No, there is no date button. The button name is date and time. So this statement is wrong because the name of the button is date and time. Button allows you to insert date and time in your document. Number two, once you close the paint window, the drawing is put on your page in the document. Is it right or wrong? When you close the paint window, the drawing is put directly on your page, or you have to save it and then insert? Yes, this statement is right. You don't have to like save it and insert. When you close the drawing paint window, then your drawing is on your page. Like you don't have to do anything. You just have to close it. So this statement is right. Okay, image button has option to change your picture with another one from the computer. Image button has an option to change your picture with another one from the computer. So there is no image button, there is a picture button. Okay, so this statement is wrong. You saw, cross that statement. Using the start, number four, using start a list button, you can make a list of food items or school items. Is it right or wrong? Yes, it's right. With the help of start a list button, you can make a list of any items like food items or school items or your toys or whatever the list you want to make. You can do it with start a list button. Now, exercise C, page number 48. And exercise C, write the name of three buttons from insert group. Okay, you have to write the name of three buttons from the insert group. Here you can see the picture of insert group. So we will write first one, picture button, paint drawing button, date and time button. So these are the names of three buttons from the insert group. And insert group picture, like you can see the insert group on your screen, picture, paint drawing, date and time. Okay, here you can see. Now time to revise the exercise of chapter number 12, more about computer parts, exercise A, B, C, D, E and F. and page number 65 to 67. So get ready, open page number 65, chapter 12, more about computer parts. 65, page number 65. Okay, page number 65, exercise A, fill in the blank with the correct word. You can see the word bank. We just have to read the statement and fill in the correct word. So start with number A. Number one, a dash has an internal speaker and a microphone. Okay, name the device. You have to tell the name of the device that has internal speaker and a microphone. Scanner, printout, headset, or mic? Yes, very good. Headset has an internal speaker and a microphone. Number two, a dash looks like a photocopy machine. Which looks like a photocopy machine? Is it scanner, printout, or mic? Yes, scanners look like a photocopy machine. Let's move on. Number three. Number three statement is, a microphone is mostly called as a printout or mic. Which one is the right? Printout or mic? Yes, a microphone is mostly called as a mic. Very good. Number four, the printed paper that comes out of the printer is called a printout. Very good. The printed paper that comes out of the printer is known as printout. Now move on to number B, exercise B. Page number 65, name the following computer devices. Names are given up like in the word bank: scanner, microphone, speaker, and printer. Read the sentence and write the correct device. Name of the correct device. Okay. A device used for printing. What is the name of device? Is it scanner, microphone, speaker, or printer? Well done, everyone. It's printer. So, a device used for printing is a printer. Okay, now number two. A device used for listening to the sound. Is it scanner, microphone, or speaker? Yes, it's speaker. Like, we can hear the sound or listen to the sound with the help of speaker, not microphone or scanner. Now, number three. A device used to record voice on the computer, is it scanner or microphone? Which device we will use if we want to record our voice? We will use scanner or microphone? Microphone. We are going to use microphone. So, a device used to record voice on the computer is microphone. Number four. A device used for scanning pictures. Okay. The device used for scanning pictures. Scanning means to put the pictures in your computer to move. So, this device means a device used for scanning pictures is scanner. Okay. Scanner is the device that is used for scanning pictures. Now, let's move on to exercise C. Take the right and cross the wrong sentence. Page number 66. Number 1. Anything on the paper when scan goes inside the computer. Is it right or wrong? Anything that is on the paper when you scan that paper that goes inside the computer. Yes, it's right. Number 2. A microphone can be used for listening sounds. We will use microphone to listen sound or to record sound. Yes, microphone is used to record sound, not for listening. So this statement is wrong. Number 3, a printer can print in both black and white and color. Yes, we can have a black and white and color pictures or the printout. So this statement is right. Number 4, a headset is placed over the head for listening and talking. Is it right or wrong? Yes, it's a right one. We can use headset and we are able to hear the sound and also use as a microphone. Good. Now, number five, a printer prints whatever we type or draw on the computer. Is it right or wrong? Yes, it's right. We can print anything or whatever we type or draw on the computer. We can print that. Number six, a microphone gives out sound from the computer. A microphone gives out sounds from the computer. Is it right or wrong? It's wrong. So what's the right one? Speakers give out sounds from the computer, not the microphone. Okay, now moving on to number seven, a printer can print pictures only. Is it right? No, it's not right. We can print any written form of the text or anything that is being that you have typed into the computer. So that sentence is wrong. Okay, now dear students, move on to exercise D. In exercise D, page number 66, we have to circle the computer devices that works with paper. Okay, the first picture is of microphone. Okay, now second picture is of printer. Third one is speaker. And the fourth one is scanner. Now, we have to circle the devices that works with paper. Microphone work with paper? No, it doesn't work with paper. Printer works with paper? Yes, printer needs paper. Then speaker? No. And the last one is scanner. Yes, we need paper for the scanner. So these are the two devices, printer and paper. These two devices work with a paper. Now exercise E, page number 67. Mark the computer device that works with sound. Okay, so you have to mark those devices that works with a sound. Number one is speaker, printer, headset, and fourth one is microphone. So which one is the right one? Speakers work with the sound, as with the help of speaker we can hear the sound. Not a printer, but headset also has speaker, internal speaker. So these are the two devices that works with sound. Okay, now last exercise of this chapter. Exercise F. Name all the computer devices given below. Look at the picture. Everyone, look at the picture and tell the name of the device. The first one is printer. Very good. Second one is speaker. Good. Third one is microphone. Okay, now the fourth one is scanner, and the third one is the third one is mic or microphone. So the third one is microphone, and fourth one is scanner, and the fifth one is headset. So these are the names of the devices, computer devices. Printer, speaker, microphone, scanner, and headset. Now, it's okay. Hope all of you have, if you missed any exercise, all of you have done it. Now, in our upcoming lecture, we are going to revise all of the exercises, worksheet exercises. All of the worksheets, all of the exercises that are mentioned in worksheet, we are going to devise these worksheet, five worksheets. There are five worksheets of five chapters. So we will revise all of these worksheets. And dear students, if you have any question, you can ask in WhatsApp group. Your computer teacher will answer all of your questions. If you have any question, then you can ask. Okay, thank you for listening. Take care of yourselves and Allah Hafiz, everyone.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام علیکم پیارے بچوں, امید ہے کہ آپ سب خیریت سے ہوں گے اور دعا ہے کہ اللہ تعالیٰ آپ سب کو اپنے حفظ و امان میں رکھے. آپ جیسا کہ آپ سب کو پتہ ہے یہ آپ کا عربی کا پیریڈ ہے. میں عربی کی ٹیچر مسز امارہ زبیر ہوں. آپ سب بچوں کو اس کلاس میں خوش آمدید کہتی ہوں. جی پیارے بچوں, آپ سب بچوں کو پتہ ہے کہ یہ آپ کا عربین ویک سٹارٹ ہو چکا ہے. پیارے بچوں, آج ہم تصاویر کے نام عربی میں دہرائیں گے انشاءاللہ. ٹھیک ہے, تو سب سے پہلے ہم شروع کرتے ہیں. تصاویر دی گئی ہیں اور ان کے نام آپ نے عربی میں اور اردو میں یاد کرنے ہیں. مجھے امید ہے کہ آپ سب بچوں کو یہ نام پہلے سے یاد ہوں گے. ٹھیک ہے, جس بچے نے یاد نہیں کیے وہ دوبارہ دھیان سے سنیں اور انہیں یاد کرنے کی کوشش کریں. ٹھیک ہے بیٹا, تو چلیں شروع کرتے ہیں. سب سے پہلے ہے, یہ دیکھیے کس کی پکچر ہے, ڈک, بطخ. تو بطخ کو عربی میں کیا کہتے ہیں, بتا. بتا کیا کہتے ہیں, بتا, بطخ. اس کے بعد ہے ٹرین. ٹرین کو کیا کہتے ہیں, قطار. قطار, یہ دیکھیے آپ سب کو ٹرین کا پتا ہے نا. ٹرین کو کیا کہتے ہیں عربک میں, قطار. قطار. اس کے بعد یہ دیکھیے جی, یہ کیا ہے, کشتی. کشتی کو کیا کہا جاتا ہے, کارب. کارب, کشتی کو کیا کہا جاتا ہے, کارب. اس کے بعد سائیکل. جی سائیکل کو کیا کہتے ہیں, دراجہ. دراجہ, ٹھیک ہے, سائیکل کو کیا کہتے ہیں, دراجہ. اس کے بعد یہ دیکھیے یہ کیا ہے, یہ کیا ہے, جہاز. جہاز کو کیا کہا جاتا ہے, طیارہ. طیارہ, جہاز کو کیا کہا جاتا ہے, طیارہ. ٹھیک ہے جی. اس کے بعد ہے مچھلی, فش. مچھلی کو کیا کہتے ہیں عربی میں, سمک. سمک کیا کہا جاتا ہے, سمک. اونٹ, اس کے بعد ہے اونٹ. اونٹ کو کیا کہتے ہیں, جمل. جمل, جمل. چڑیا, چڑیا کو کیا کہا جاتا ہے, عصفور. عصفور, چڑیا, عصفور. عصفور, اس کے بعد یہ کیا ہے, زرافہ. زرافہ, زرافے کو اردو میں بھی زرافہ ہی کہتے ہیں. ٹھیک ہے, زرافہ. زرافہ, اس کے بعد یہ بٹر فلائی, تتلی. اس کو کیا کہا جاتا ہے, فراشا. فراشا, فراشا, فراشا. جی اس کے بعد یہ دیکھیے یہ تصاویر ہیں اور ان کے یہ نام. یہ دیکھیے درخت. درخت کو کیا کہتے ہیں, شجرا. درخت کو کیا کہتے ہیں, شجرا. شجر, شجر, ٹھیک ہے. عصفورا, عصفورا, چڑیا. عصفورا, چڑیا. غصن, غصن, تنا. تنا, غصن, تنا. غصن, تنا. اوش, اوش کسے کہتے ہیں, گھونسلے کو. گھونسلہ, اوش گھونسلہ, اوش گھونسلہ. سعید, ہیپی, خوش. سعید کے کیا ہے معنی, خوش. سعید خوش. حزین, غمگین, پریشان. حزین, غمگین, سیڈ. حزین, غمگین, سیڈ. جی بیٹا, تو اب آگے ہیں. یہ دیکھیے جی, یہ تو گیمز کے نام آئے ہیں. تو سب سے پہلے کیا ہے, قرت القدم. قرت القدم, فٹ بال. فٹ بال, قرت القدم, فٹ بال. شد الحبل. شد الحبل, رسا کشی. رسا کھینچنا, شد الحبل, رسا کشی. یوم الریاضی. یوم الریاضی, اسپورٹس ڈے. یوم الریاضی, اسپورٹس ڈے. اس کے بعد یہ دیکھیے یہ پکچر کس کی ہے, کا. कप की ट्रॉफी की कास कास कप या ट्रॉफी कास कास जी उस तो जी बच्चों अब हम इन तस्वीर के नाम पढ़ेंगे तो सबसे पहली तस्वीर देखिए किसकी है कुर्रतुस्सिल्ला बास्केटबॉल कुर्रतुस्सिल्ला बास्केटबॉल कुर्रतुस्सिल्ला बास्केटबॉल ये देखिए जी ये किसकी है सबाहा 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 स्विमिंग तैराकी सबाहा स्विमिंग तैराकी ठीक है उसके बाद ये देखिए ये क्या है सबाक 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 दौड़ रेस सबाक दौड़ रेस कुर्रतुल यद वॉलीबॉल कुर्रतुल यद वॉलीबॉल जी तो उसके बाद बेटे ये देखिए ये अब है जानवरों के नाम ठीक है आप सब बच्चों ने ये नाम पहले भी अपनी बुकलेट में लिखे भी हैं इनको कलर भी आपने किया होगा ठीक है तो आज हम इनको दोबारा रिवाइज करते हैं हदीकतुल हिवानात हाँ जी तो सबसे पहले कौन सी पिक्चर है एलिफेंट की तो एलिफेंट को क्या कहते हैं अरेबिक में हाथी को क्या कहते हैं फील 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 जी तो उसके बाद कौन सा है गजाल गजाल हर हिरन गजाल हिरन गजाल हिरन उसके बाद ये देखिए घोड़ा घोड़े को क्या कहते हैं हसान 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 अब ये देखिए ये क्या है शीप दुम्बा खरूफ 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 क्या है ये खरूफ जी तो अब है ये देखिए पहली पिक्चर किस चीज की है कैट की कैट को क्या कहते हैं कत्ता 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 उसके बाद क्या है डॉग तो डॉग को क्या कहते हैं कल्ब कल्ब डॉग को क्या कहते हैं कल्ब जी तो उसके बाद ये देखिए ये क्या है ऊंट कैमल कैमल को क्या कहते हैं जमल जमल ठीक है जी क्या है ये जमल और ये क्या है जी सब बच्चों को इसका पता है लायन लायन को क्या कहते हैं अरबी में असद 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 क्या पढ़ेंगे इसको असद जी तो उसके तो जी प्यारे बच्चों ये था आज का आपका काम उम्मीद है आपको इसकी समझ आ गई होगी यही आपका बेटे होमवर्क भी है अगर किसी बच्चे को कोई प्रॉब्लम हो किसी वर्ड की समझ नहीं आई तो आप अपनी अरेबिक की टीचर से व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप पर पूछ सकते हैं ठीक है जी बेटा इसके साथ ही मुझे इजाज़त दीजिए अल्लाह ताला आपको कामयाबियां कामरानियां अता फरमाए और सेहत व तंदरुस्ती अता फरमाए पे आमीन अल्लाह हाफिज फी अमानिल्लाह।